your life.
Colin's here, and that's Colin's dog Dolly, and we'll explain why Dolly's here in just a minute.
Well, but she's lovely, she's here for the talking thing.
Yeah, but she's here for the food.
Yes,
can you get some more of that food, please? Because she's getting a bit wild in the break.
Didn't she? I mean, didn't you say that you got her from an animal sanctuary because she had two previous owners? She was so hungry they couldn't keep up with her.
Well, they used to take her out for walks, and she'd go and devour strangers' picnics as they're picnicking in parks in London. So two homes rejected her, and we've ended up with her.
How old is she?
But, well, she's five and about 300 stone. Look at that.
Dolly.
Who needs a machine, right, to tell you what that's saying? She's just saying more, now, here.
And as she's deaf, she's probably saying, what?
Oh, she's eating again.
Anyway, listen, let's talk about Doctor Who for a second.
Yes, let's do that.
You still go to the conventions, don't you?
Yeah. I do, yes.
As one of the stars.
When invited, yes.
Because you did it for 2 years, didn't you?
Three. 83 to 86.
You see, the first reign of the Cybermen in black and white, which I remember from the sort of late 60s, early 70s, I found terrifying. But looking at them, I can't understand why I was frightened of them, looking at them now.
Well, that's the same about... Mind you, Daleks still work. I think anyone who's been frightened of a Dalek will remain frightened of a Dalek.
Literally. The new merchandise is fantastic. This is new in the shop. I would have killed for that as a kid. I would have killed for that.
I haven't seen that before.
But isn't it amazing that kids are still buying this as toys, even though it's not been on screen for such a long time?
There is something...
Oh, right.
There is something basically frightening about that design.
Yeah.
I was once alone in the studio, walking across to go back to my dressing room during the supper break, and the operator was actually cleaning the inside of the Dalek, and I didn't know, and the thing turned as I was walking across. And I'd been working with it all week, and I got a sudden... God, that Dalek's looking at me. Just for a second.
Time to leave the
studio. To me, what really frightened me was the thought of the shrivelled, horrible, mutant creatures inside.
Oh, never mind.
You saw the guys who operated it, did you?
All right, and there's a new film coming out, or the BBC are making a film, a one-off film.
There's a rumour a week
about who's going to be the new Doctor, when the new film's coming out. It may happen. The BBC is certainly getting more kind of live about being interested in it again, as opposed to just dismissing everything. Yeah. I think it's a shame.
There are
generations that haven't got their Doctor.
If Michael Grade is watching, or is it Sir Michael Grade now? Who's a very nice chap, Michael Grade, but he was on who killed, he killed Doctor Who. He put it, so this is from the Daleks to Michael Grade.
Exterminate!
Wonderful.
And that's not the first time that's been said either. the fans.
There's Dolly over there.
We'll get him back, don't we? The play.
Just tell us about this play, because I know it's not a new play, but in fact it's the second time you've been in it, isn't it? But it says it's a comedy thriller, and I saw the title Corpse, and I thought, fine.
It's a nice and light title, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's the exclamation mark that does it.
What is it? Right.
Well, corpse as in the theatrical slang for laughing on stage when you're not supposed to,
Oh, with a double entendre on the word dead body?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's my character is a kind of naff alleged major who's hired by one twin to kill the other.
Yeah.
And I'm totally incompetent.
It's two twins. Are they both
played by Mark McGann?
And you played that role originally, didn't you?
Not originally, no. Originally it was played by Keith Baxter.
Oh, right.
And 2 years later I did it in the West End at the Strand Theatre.
Mm.
Back in 1987, 15 years ago.
Mm. But you're rubbish, basically.
I'm a total incompetent murderer.
You can't do it.
But it takes a little while for that to... And I'm being manipulated by this awful out-of-work actor.
Mm.
No, I'm not talking about Mark McGann. I mean, that's what he plays.
Yeah.
In order to kill his twin brother, also played by him. So there's lots of quick changes and
it's an award-winning play, isn't it?
It is.
Won many awards, So where are you at the moment? I know you've been touring all over the place, but where are you?
Bromley this week.
Yeah.
Edinburgh next week.
Mm.
It's going on to Christmas places like Richmond, Coventry, Poole, ending up in Milton Keynes before Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's Panto, and then it's back out with this again next spring.
Oh, good. Well, good
so
luck
it's going
with
to
it.
Next June.
Good luck with it. Can we get the dog back in now, please? Just somebody, go on, bring it in. Matt, if you're on camera. Come on.
This is my friend Carol, who's very kindly brought the dog up.
Hello,
thank you, Carol. She's much calmer with you than with the owner, I'll tell you that.
Okay. Come on, up you get.
Up on the seat, good. because this is where we're going to get the dog to talk. Because when we ask my mum's dog, Holly, to speak, Holly goes sort of, do you remember? She says, speak, Colin. She goes, actually, I've got to be honest, that wasn't an impression of the dog.
No.
I think I just passed
I
the camera.
I think Holly would be very angry.
I think I just passed the camera. That was a joke and you spoke over the punchline. Anyway, no, but she does make that noise. But what's she really saying? When Dolly here barks at Colin, right, what would she be telling you if she was actually able to speak to you? Well, step forward, Bowlingual. It's an incredible computer program from Japan which translates woofs into words. And just before the first ever interview with a dog on live television, Dolly, you are that dog. Here are the results of tests earlier today. One slight snag. The machine speaks in Japanese. So we had to send a translator along. Here we go. Dolly was making so much noise that the calculation, we didn't hear any of that, but I hope it worked. This is Mieko. What?
Mieko.
Mieko. How do you pronounce your surname?
Mieko.
Mieko. And what?
Wasio. Mieko Wasio.
Okay,
yeah.
Our translator. And as you can see, we've put the computer on Dolly's collar there. All right, so let's go. Do you want to switch it on while Dolly barks? Okay.
It's
good.
On. You.
Got a translation there?
She turned it off now.
This is. Usai, which means. Shut up.
Means shut up.
Shut up!
It's you that said shut up, Dolly.
Shut up.
Right, what was that?
Oh, wait a minute.
I'm hungry.
Second. No, not bowing, so.
Okay, do another one. Do another one. She's been very obliging to bow.
She's just right. Very greedy.
You got something there?
Yes.
Oh, it says, yada usobani konaide, which means don't touch me.
Oh, no, I don't
this
think
doesn't
so.
Seem to be working.
I don't think so.
Let's see what happens.
Okay,
right, no more food, right.
Yeah, she's
Dolly,
deaf.
Dolly, Dolly, Dolly. Dolly, see, one word from me.
Look, Dolly. Look. Look, Dolly.
Sadly, you can't eat it, darling.
Okay, let's try something else. Let's do a human bark and see if... Now, I'm going to do a bark of a dog that I think would be angry and would want to scare you off. Let's just give it a go, all right?
Okay.
You ready? Okay. Oh, do it at the collar, of course. Sorry about this. Don't bite me, Dolly, for God's sake.
You scared me.
How was that? How was that?
Wait a second. Oh, it says, mo yan nacha na.
Which is?
I don't like it.
I don't like it? No, I think we're getting somewhere. Let's try another one. Okay. Sorry, Dolly, but you're out of work, Dolly. You blew it. Okay. Come here.
Right,
try that.
Like
I'm taking my life in my hands with this company here. All right?
Okay, she's deaf.
I didn't catch.
You didn't get it?
Get it.
All right.
Sorry.
Can we take it off the collar easily?
Don't you think you've had enough?
Yeah, there we go. There we go.
I think Dolly's had enough.
One more. There we go. I got it. Okay, ready? Go on, you do one.
Oh, no, I can't imitate
do
a dog.
Yeah, all right.
What have we got?
It says, nanka ki ni iranai, which means I don't like it.
Yes, I think so. Last one. I'm going to do a bark that a dog would do if it wanted to have friendly relations with a female dog. Right? How was that?
That doesn't sound much.
What again?
It says, nene moto asonde, play with me.
Play with me! Result, you see, it works for humans pretending to be dogs, but not dogs being dogs, which is a great shame, but fun.
Actually, they're inventing one, a similar one, for cats, so you can talk to your cats, and you can only get them in Japan at the moment. I think this is actually the only one in the UK right now, but they are developing them over here, so they speak
Lots
to you
fun.
In English.
For all the family.
Colin, good luck
Can't
with the
wait.
Play.
Thank
Lovely
you very
to see
much
you. Indeed. And the fans.
If it had been made of chocolate, it would have worked.
Colin's gone already. Mieko, thank you very much.